Welcome, welcome to the so-called most peaceful ERPNX conference, guys. Hope you had a good lunch and really missed actually, apart from the talks, the in-person discussion we used to have at the conference, people coming from different countries and giving name to faces. I hope that day comes soon again. Really hopeful to that. Myself Umair Sayed, co-founder of Frappe Technologies, and I'll be presenting on how we as a community can collaborate to grow our own whole ERPNX ecosystems. So my talk will be around that. Firstly, I would like to give my take on where exactly Frappe stands where exactly community stands. On my honest take, let's see how it proceeds. Okay, so this is what was the scenario few months down the line. For many years, we at Frappe Technologies were addressing small and medium enterprises. We had very cost-effective plans, and most of our customers were like 5-10 users, and very very minimum budget. So I think that's where we stood. We took a call that okay, what we need to do is we being an OEM actually. Need to target a very well-defined set of customers. So now the Frappe plans, which currently exist, is actually designed for the large and medium enterprises. Whereas SMBs, we are only serving them for hosting via FC. And which means basically we have given up the SMB market as Frappe Technologies. That's all available for the community Frappe partners to take it up and serve them end to end. So that's one thing we as Frappe have done. I would like to take my honest take on where we stand as a community. And before I convey that, I would like to pick an analogy, pick an example. So please just take it as an example. No intentions to kind of get political or hurt anyone. There was this war, the rebellion by the Indian sepoys who were serving British Indian or the East Asia company of at that point of time. Apparently. So what happened is actually the Mangal Pandey incident happened. He sacrificed his life. There was a rebellion by Indian sepoys against the Britishers of that point of time. Initially, the way it progressed, there was this region called Awadh, which currently is now UP Bihar region in India. And the rebellions were really united. The Indian sepoys were really united. And initially, we basically had Britishers on run. Okay. And Britishers actually were, there in clusters. So they were losing, whereas the rebellions who were united really were winning. But as war progressed and it went from northeast to northwest towards Delhi, eventually what happened is basically the Indian rebellions started forming clusters and forming different battles, whereas Britishers actually really got united and really fought together and took over Delhi. So in both the scenarios, right, the beginning and the end, the learning is basically the side which was kind of united and not distributed into multiple clusters eventually won. What I'm trying to get at is basically for us, everyone in the community, the opportunity is so huge, right? It's a $1 billion market. There are tons of reports out there and whatnot. But what actually is happening, in my opinion, is basically all of us as a companies are fighting our own battle. Each of our partners, right, also have some expertise. For example, we have some partners who are like tele veterans. And they have huge, they have access to huge, network, and they basically kind of find, problem on the technical front. There are some service providers who are tech savvy. They have that as a expertise, as their forte. But they don't have a knack on the functional side or on the implementation side. We as a community or as an individuals so are not really capable to present ourselves to enterprises who basically want a lot more than just product expertise. And this is basically what currently is happening. But what actually we can do, right? We can really fight this out together. What I mean is basically, let's pick India as a territory. The guy who, for example, like Mr. Vikram Seth, who's like a veteran into the tele ecosystem, can help us open that market. Let's say Atul, who has very good understanding of business and tech, can help us make tools for helping, onboard the SMB customers. We have Karthikian, let's say, who's very excited about integrations. We have Celia, who's very good at financing and help us understand what exactly the, statutory compliance requirement is coming forward so that we can be ready in advance. And many such implementers who can basically, help us win this battle together. So that's what actually probably what we are missing, not working together. And if I can give you a best example of, a community which has done this together and got it right, is Wikipedia, right? In today's time, we can't even imagine putting together a huge amount of information as Wikipedia has done together. I doubt if it was possible that would have been possible with hiring by one organization. The amount of contribution which is made is only possible with the kind of model and enthusiasm the Wikipedia community has. So if we have to achieve something as big as Wikipedia, right? I think we have an example right in front of us. It's actually a marvel right in front of us to take an inspiration from. So yesterday, I think Rushabh presented about Frappe stack I'll just try and highlight basically what our roles can be as an OEM and as service providers. So the bottom layer is the Frappe Cloud, the infrastructure layer, which is the most complex part. We will suggest let's leave it on Frappe Cloud, right? Let's expert handle it because there are so many moving pieces. Initially, all of us, even partners used to think that, okay, we can just run up a site on DigitalOcean and AWS, but there are so many unknowns we don't visualize, which later on haunt us and doesn't allow us to, let's say, even upgrade our customer to latest version in future. So we'll suggest let's leave the hosting part on Frappe Cloud. We are enhancing and I think partners are already appreciating it way too much. Frappe framework is basically our tech layer. I think that's what bring us together, the heart and soul. And then on top of the tech, then we have a product layer. Right. So just like Naveen talked about the ERP next, the core, the CRM, there'll be multiple applications coming from us as an OEM. And then of course, with Marketplace, now we'll also have the FC Marketplace apps. You can also have your custom applications. Right. So that's where the community come in. And then on top of it, we have a service layer wherein, we have these products like Frappe School and Frappe Consulting. Amit talked about in brief, and of course we have the Frappe consulting, the partner consulting, which is already there in place, and you guys are serving them very well. So there's a scope for all of us to coexist and make it happen. What Frappe, the direction Frappe is going is basically we have our own lead and opportunities, our own funnel. But as we are converting them with our own expertise, with our own plans, we are trusting partners to do the last mile deliveries. And that's something which has already happened with some of the partners. And we look forward to go this direction rather than Frappe getting into last mile services. We would be very keen to scale on that front with partners, whereas so that Frappe can be like stay focused on the product and platform side. So that's an initiative already taken by Frappe, trusting partners. Even for businesses, right? So Shitish talk about helping, can Frappe help in assuring enterprise customers? Because their requirement is somewhat different than SMB customer. They want a partner who would, stay around and give the product warranty, give the platform warranty the way they want, right? So what is again already happening, at least with the Frappe partners, is they collaborate with us. We are making joint pitch to the enterprises, and we win the customer together. But when it comes to last mile delivery, again, we want to scale further with partners. So there's a huge scope for partners to, you know, associate and do the last mile delivery. And again, it's a revenue model for them. So that's how I think we can kind of win enterprises together. And there's a huge opportunity even on the business front for partners to collaborate with us. And lastly comes the product itself, right? How we talk about so many gaps in the last Q&A. How do we resolve it? And we have the very vibrant developers community also, right? Who are already making contributions via Frappe Cloud. So it's a huge add, I think, to our stack, Frappe Cloud Marketplace. Now even partners and community members have the platform so that they can basically make the product contributions directly. So if you look at the overall scenario, if we talk about product, if we talk about sales, if we talk about deliveries, community and Frappe partners is at the heart of it, is at the very center of it. So we want to basically, when we talk about strategy, growth and everything, we are considering a community everywhere and giving space and entry point for the community to collaborate with us and make it happen together. Eventually it's an open source solution, right? It's like a double-edged sword. It has so many benefits. Any one of us can download and, you know, give it a run. At the same time, it also has its own challenges. If the opportunity is so big and so large for us to take or lose, right? And only if, say, let's say Frappe survives, we'll be able to be the maintainers and give it back to community eventually. And if we don't do it right, so the market is brutal. We always like appreciate each other, the kind of contribution we make and everything, right? But eventually, if we don't capture the market the way it deserves, the quality of product we have, right? With that quality, if you're not taking it, market is brutal, right? So they won't discount us. And if we don't do it, then maybe someone else will do it. So the opportunity is right here for us to work together and make ERP Next a de facto ERP, right? Just like there are other accounting applications who are kind of de facto, we have this opportunity to make it together, and we can do it together only, my honest opinion. So while I make this pitch, I want to quickly brief about the Frappe partnership. There are plans which is already there on the website, so I won't get into the specific, the gold, silver, bronze partnership. You can see the differentiation right on the website. I'll suggest you see it quickly if you're interested and get in touch with us. What I want to highlight is basically how Frappe partnership helps you attend your end customers better. So there is what end customer actually look for, right? They want assurance on the product. They want a product they can really rely on. And they want a service provider in the backend who can basically ensure that their product will be working. And we as an OEM can bring in that factor. We can assure customer that, we have a track record that 13 years in working, right? The other point of it, basically the stability of a service provider itself. The customer often ask, right? What ensure that you'll be there for us, serving us in future, right? Because they are looking at marrying, not just subscribing, with a software solution they go ahead with. So Frappe has a track record of 13 years. It's an open source anyways. That's also something which we can, which is there for us to justify our point. At the same time, they want extendable platform to meet their future needs. Typically from this enterprise point of view, and at the same time, they want affordability. So with open source and zero licensing, we can bring this all together as a stack and present ourselves. And how Frappe partnership helps our service provider? We allow Frappe partners to subscribe to our services and present it as a bundle service to their customers, right? So if you are a Frappe partner, you can buy our SMB plan, enterprise plan, and ensure Frappe guarantee to your end customer. So they are also assured, and customer really want it, right? Since the RPEs are kind of mission critical, given that our plans are also affordable, they want this kind of assurity at that cost, at that price. So, and we are seeing that it's really flying very well in the partner ecosystem. I'm sorry. And then we also assist you in deal closure. If you have an enterprise customer, we'll be very happy to collaborate, validate the lead, so that we save each other's time and then make a joint pitch to customer and help you close that together. We have the SME plan launch very soon. I think I already mentioned it. And then we also have assets and very focused weekly webinars conducted for our partners. So that also kind of keep them posted before everyone else. And we have a very well revived PRM solution, which is partner relationship management, which allows you to register your customer, register your lead, so that we can help you close them, subscribe to more credits, track your balance credits, register your queries, get support on that. So it's a platform for the partners to get end-to-end service on their end customers via Frappe. And we have all the support plans, which is out there already, enterprise support plan. And then we have the SMB support plan, which I mentioned, which is really flying for the SMB customers. So that you can assure your end customers on product warranty. And we are open for suggestions. Let's say if you see that there is better model wherein Frappe and partner can approach customer and do a business better, right? Eventually, that does matter. We are open to your suggestions. So that's where I'll end my talk, and I'll let you hear it directly from the Frappe partners who are lined up next. To hear it from the horse's mouth directly. So I think this is it. If there are questions, I'll be happy to take. And if time allows.
Thank you so much, Umair, on the talk on partnership. If there are any questions that you want to ask Umair, please go ahead.
Okay.
So your reviews.
There's a question from Mahesh, is PRM live? So it is in the final stages of testing, Mitesh. We are hoping it will be live in a week or so.
Your honest reviews on partnership business alignment can also be discussed here with Umair.
Yeah, Umair, Kanaiya this side, Kanaiya, yeah.
Hi, Kanaiya.
Yeah. So if for any specific customers, if you would like to bundle a package, though it is not a standard offerings from Frappe, but some kind of offerings you would like to propose as a bundled, the combined with Indictrans and the Frappe offerings. So is there anyone in your team who can help us in bundling that package in a correct way?
Yeah, I think we'll have to estimate the opportunity itself. The customers you always appreciate if you can kind of standardize plan rather than having something ad hoc, right? That's something which is not scalable. So if you have a suggestion that we can kind of so if you have an opportunity. Because enterprise generally, it's not generally a SOAP selling. So we can always
for the enterprise kind of customers, which are more than SMB and might be at the enterprise level. But some kind of offerings we need to bundle it in such a way that it might help us to close the deal rather than we are just offering like you said, it is not easy that we are just selling a SOAP.
Definitely, Kanaiya. Now, there is some subjectivity to your question, so I can't provide an exact answer to that. But I can definitely assure you that we can collaborate and work on it together and give a kind of deal which helps us close it.